this sprayed. I did a little spray fixative, and now it's time to throw down a glaze over this. So keep your fingers crossed. Oh, yeah, that's too much. That's why you do it off to the side first. Oh yeah, this is gonna be good. Ooh, it's time to change the water. Water's starting to smell. There we go. Yeah. Alright, put that back in there. Let me got some runoff here. That's something I may actually end up having to do. I might have to switch to a different area when doing this. Maybe go downstairs to the painting part of the studio and start doing some of this stuff. Because it ain't helping the table any either. But anyway, there it is. There we go. Now, what I need to do is I just need to let it dry. And then we'll come back in. Well, actually, while it's still wet, I can do a little bit of something here. Let me get some of this darker blue. I can work some of that in here. And might as well, while it's here, try and throw in some darker blues here and there. Ain't gonna hurt nothing. There we go. Let's do that. I'll come back into it and pull some stuff out. There we go. Let me get a paper towel. Let me pull out some of these darker areas with a paper towel. A little bit of texture in here. There we go. And the rest of it will just hold off until it all dries, and then we'll start going back into it. So let's let it dry, and then we'll see where we go from there. Alright, so we dried it up. For the most part, we still got some wet drips here and there, but I just want to kind of work back into this a little bit while it's still a little fresh, but the main part's dry there. And I'm gonna work in some darks. Let's see here. Where is my, kind of got a little over the line there. There we go. A little more water here. There we go. There we go. Now I don't want this to be a completely finished piece. I just want it to be visually interesting here. And I'm also doing a little bit at a time. I don't want to go completely dark all at once. So that's why we're just doing a little bit here and there. Remember, you're building, always building, and the trick to building up your layers is to quit before you go too far. And that just takes experience, knowing when you're about to go too far. I think that's going to be it for the darks right now. I'm pretty happy with that for the most part. And now I'm going to go build some lights into it, I think. Actually, let me do one little thing here. I'm noticing something. there's a few light areas that I want to kind of build some darks around those light areas. Just a little bit, not much, just a hint here and there. There we go. All right, let's let this dry and we'll come back to it. Almost forgot that while I have this dark here a little wet and stuff, I want to throw some splatter in. So, just a little more visual interest. And I'll do the same thing with the lights once I get to that point with the lights. So, there we go. And let that dry and we'll be right back. Now we got this nice and dry. And I'm going to start adding some highlights into here. Little bits here and there. So let me go ahead and add some parchment first. And we'll get into some of the other stuff. Alright. It's too much. More water. Alright. Again, just build up nice and easy. That's what I want to do. And I probably went a little too dark with some of this here when I was adding that blue in. Got a little rambunctious with the blue. But that's okay. We can fix it right here. This is definitely a process, and you just need to take your time with it. Building up. Building up takes time. And what I'm doing is I'm just trying to hit all the spots where you know there's going to be light. Going to be places where light pulls up. And I'm doing pretty simple lighting with this. The lighting's just coming from above. That's another thing when you're first getting started doing stuff like this. Keep it simple, you know? Just say, all right, the light's coming from above. Where's the light gonna hit? So all you gotta do, just put in your lights. I'm gonna start mixing my orange into this. Cause I want my highlights to be a little orangey, cause it's going with the blue. It's complementary. Just a little bit, not much, right? Can always add more later. And I'm only going to be putting this orange color on the face. Take away a little bit of that. All right, just let me dry this right quick with the blow dryer. Get back to that. As you can tell, it dried very dark, which is really what I wanted.
just dry this.
Building up, building up. And remember what I said at the very beginning, I did get way too dark with this. At the very beginning, but just gotta work with what you got. I'm sorry, this is so loud. But normally I cut out the blow dryer, but I just wanted y'all to see the process. That's actually fairly quick. That's just how it is when you're working with acrylics. Real quick. Dry this. I'm brushing this orange into the blue, which is starting to make like a green, which is really nice. But it's really, really light. And again, you just gotta build it up. And again, I'm only using this on um, on the skin. There we go. This is actually the secret to how they do it in Renaissance style paintings. Of course, it'd be with oils and resins, so you get like this nice layering effect. Like Rembrandt, he had a beautiful layering technique. Rembrandt did. We just kept layers and layers of thin washes. That looking nice. Starting to look really nice. But slow and steady. Slow and steady wins the race when it comes to this. I'm gonna do a little more orange. The goal here is not to have to go back over and paint and just straight tone, you know, flat color. You don't want to have to do that. So just keep building real, real light to get exactly what you want. And eventually you get exactly what you want, and you can plop down some real strong solids, solid brush strokes. And it's only at the very, very end that you do this. Anyway, let's go work on some more of the straitjacket. And basically, I'm just going to do the same thing that I did with the face. I'm just building and building and building. I'm going to keep building with this parchment. And then at the end, I'll pop some white on it to really make it just jump. Hit it with the blow dryer. Something else I'll do at some point is I'll go back in here and I'll beef up the darks, and that'll really make it pop a little too. So. There's a few edge spots that I really want to kind of hit to make it stand out against the blue. All these edges over here. Also want to go back in and hit the face a little bit before my orange dries up. Got this real nice orange. One thing about recording all this that I'm really liking is I can look up on the screen and see how things are looking. That's really awesome. I like being able to do that. It immediately gives you a different view of what you're working on. Let's put my hand in some wet. A little here, a little there. That's nice. Yeah, I'm really liking this. Let me dry this off. Alright, so I'm just gonna try and pop a few little spots here. Just kind of afraid of this. Maybe a little too much for me. Just putting in a few little spots of orange. Now I can go back to working on the straps.
getting windy outside. There we go. Whenever you see like some of this pooling, it does like to pool because of the texture on the paper. I just go back to wherever it's pooling and just kind of push it around a smidge. That helps out. And I just keep building up and building up and building up until I get what I want. And that is how it's done. Yeah. Yeah, this is looking great. And up here, I see where it's starting to pool a little bit, so just gonna mush it around just a wee bit. Till I get exactly what I want. Nice. All right, I don't want to go over this too long. I just kind of like where it's going right now. It's pretty simple. I want to keep it simple. Got a little pooling going on here. But I'm gonna come in here with some whites here. See if I can't take this piece over the top.
Get my white.
There we go. And I do feel like I've spent a little too much time on this, but every now and then you gotta do that. Gotta get one from time to time that you spend a little extra on. Just something where the person reading this can go through and just sit there for a moment and look at it and like, oh, that's cool, you know. There we go. Yeah, that's looking really good. Eventually, a painting like this becomes one of those where you want to just keep painting it and keep painting it because it's going so well, but you got to stop. You got to stop at some point. So, that is what I'm going to end up doing here. I want to do a little bit with the hair. Give it a little extra bump here. So it doesn't get lost. And I'm gonna go back in and do a little splatter here and there. Yeah. Me get thick bristle brush. I don't want to get crazy with this, but let's see if we can get a little something in here. Yeah. There we go. Oh, almost forgot. Let me get a detailed brush here. I don't want to use that for inking. Yeah. I want to get a small detail brush here and I just want to put some straight white. I'm just hitting a few spots here where there we go. Yeah. I think we actually got something here. Super excited by this page. Gonna let it dry and might add a few little things, but it might be the end of this one. We'll see. Use up this little pile of white paint I got here and just kind of have fun with it, putting in some highlights on the straight jacket. A paper towel go. Where the heck my paper towel went anyway. And once I'm done with this, then I will do the darks and then it's done. Let's just play a little bit with this white. Few little spots here. There we go. Now it's starting to make this stuff really zing here. I'm gonna turn this a little bit so I can get at it from a few different angles. Go. Let me roll this around a little bit.
Spots that I want to get.
And as usual, I'm using too big of a brush for the space that I'm working in, but that's okay. Yeah, I'm liking that. All right.
Now, I'm gonna kind of go hog wild with some white.
There we go. That's cool. All right, so now I'm just gonna dry this piece, and then I'm gonna add in them darks, and we are good to go. All right, so this is pretty much dry, except for a little bit of the whites over in here where it's a little thicker, but that ain't gonna stop me from doing a little bit of work here. So let me just, and I'm using a colored pencil, a black colored pencil to do this. To pop up these darks here and there. I'm going to try and keep it nice and sharp too. And it ain't going to take much. And of course, it ain't going to be perfectly smooth because the texture in the paper. So, just something to remember. Yeah, that's really starting to make it pop off the page there. I'm liking it. very, very nice. Yeah. All right, now I want to get some green. Just going to do this with colored pencil. Got the green ones I'm looking for. There we go. And maybe just a smidge of light green. Here and there. Alright. Love it. Alright. I think it's time to move on to the next pages.
If you like what you're seeing here, give us a like, share, subscribe. Also, go on over to the skitscomic.com website. All videos show up there a week before they ever hit YouTube. While you're there, pick you up a comic book, print, or go ahead and get you an original piece of art. Lastly, go over to indiegogo.com and sign up for the book that you're actually watching being made right now. Thank you and have a great day.